Home theater or soundbar, which is better? This is the most common question asked by a lot of you, and this is the reason you are watching this video. Hi, my name is Soumajit and welcome to another video where we would see which one is better and what should you buy. Before I start this video, I would like to make a small request. If you are new to this channel and came here for the first time, request you to like, share and please subscribe to this channel. Also hit the bell icon to get the notification of my upcoming videos. I am glad to see the responses I have started receiving from you all in my previous videos. Please help me to grow this family much bigger. Sound quality, this is a subjective matter and differs from person to person. Where a person is happy to invest lakhs to hear clear audio quality with no artificial sound enhancement, where another person may invest similar amount of money to a real Atmos sound effect. Let me give my example. In my childhood, I have spent some time listening to music in an Iowa and Sony music system. I cannot remember the Iowa model name, but for Sony, it was DHC-AZ2D. Trust me guys, till date I am not getting the same sweetness in any of the music systems or home theater I have been listening to. Now let's get back to the main question. Is soundbar is better than a home theater? As per my knowledge, both of them are equally good and serve the purposes they are made for. I am gonna talk about in this video what are benefits using soundbar and what are the benefits using home theater. Both of them have few pros and cons. We will talk about it in details in this video. First, talk about a home theater. The basic expectation from a home theater is to have at least 5 speakers. 2 speakers at front next to your TV and 1 center speaker and 2 speaker at the back of your sitting position. And to deliver a cinematic experience, it should have a subwoofer, where the soundbar is basically a bar where it contains speaker in it. It has at least 2 speakers in it, but as you go extremely high-end models, the soundbar can also have 10 to 15 speakers as well. It depends on the brand and how expensive the soundbar is. Soundbar is a significant upgrade from a default TV speaker. Let's talk about the pros of the soundbar. Firstly, they are extremely easy to set up. It requires only a single cable to get connected with your TV. The cable can be HDMI or digital coaxial or optical cable or simple RCA cable. Nowadays, most 4K TVs come with Bluetooth. Therefore, you can connect your soundbar wirelessly as well with your TV. But here, I would like you to read the manual. Ask the seller about the connectivity options before buying anything. Secondly, it is very convenient as you do not have to deal with multiple cables and bulky speakers. As it requires single cable to connect with TV, it looks neat and clean. There are soundbars which come along with subwoofer. They also sometimes come with Bluetooth. Therefore, you can also hide your subwoofer at the desired position. No need to worry about the cables. Thirdly, it is not expensive like home theater. You can easily get it from 4000 rupees. However, the sound quality would be barely better than your TV. However, as you spend like 30 to 40,000 on a soundbar, you would get better sound quality. However, at the same price point, a home theater is going to give you way better sound quality. Now let's talk about the cons of a soundbar. If you do not pay a significant amount of money, you cannot get anywhere close to the sound quality like a home theater. You cannot upgrade your soundbar all that much as the speakers are already fixed in the bar. If you are not happy with the speakers, you need to buy a different soundbar. But again, upgrading wireless speakers or wireless sub can be done in premium soundbars. Lastly, wireless connectivity is not all that good. The sound quality you can expect through HDMI or optical cable. I cannot expect the same quality from a wireless connection. Now let's move on to a home theater. Any home theater requires an amplifier or receiver to provide power to each speaker. What is the difference between amplifier and AV receiver? I will make a separate video on this. Here I'm referring to 5.1 home theater system. Home theater comes with lot of choices. You can have 7.1, 7.2, 9.2 or 11.2.4 etc. For few of you, it may be jargons, but I will introduce with you guys soon in a separate video. Let's first talk about the pros of the home theater system. Firstly, that they will have a superior audio quality from a soundbar, and this is the end of story, period. If you set up your speakers right at the right position and do the audio calibration properly, it will sound way better than a soundbar. The reason is simple. It has bigger space to drivers to move. When you look at home theater speakers, those are pretty large in size. So bigger the size of a speaker, typically the better the sound. Continuing to the superior sound quality, home theater speaker produces much wider sound. It gives you opportunity to place the speaker much further apart to hear stereo effect more clearly. You can hear the sound moving from one direction to another very clearly, which may not be that clear in a small soundbar because of the distance between two speakers. It gives you opportunity to place the speaker much further apart to hear stereo effect more clearly, which may not be that clear in a small soundbar because of the distance between two speakers. Typical home theater would have lot more power, means it would help speakers to sound louder and better. Secondly, there are wide variety of speakers are available in the market to choose from. There are Yamaha, Bogue Audio, Klipsch, Pioneer, Focal, Yamo, etc. Other premium brands offer you bookshelf speaker, tower speaker, etc. Definitely need to have a dedicated room for this. There are speakers come with nice grill which can be easily blended into the wall. Next up is the upgradability. An AV receiver can come with multiple choices and enough power, means you can start with 5.1, later on you can upgrade or add more speaker to make it 7.1 or 9.2 or 11.2.4 with the same AV receiver as long as your receiver has all the required ports. Next up is the longevity. As long as you are taking care of your system and ensure the speakers are getting the required power, not less, not over, it will survive years after years and continue to provide you the nice audio quality. Now let's go over to the cons of home theater system. Home theater is a little complicated to set up. It is not a plug and play setup like soundbar. If you at least want to go for 5.1 speaker system, you need to deal with multiple cables. You need to do proper wiring to hide maximum cables. Also, any point of time if you feel like moving your TV to a different room or to a different wall, you need to set it up once again from the beginning. Next up is picking up the components. If you are buying a home theater in a box, those are definitely good choice where you get everything from receiver to speaker to cables, but you need to pay a lot for this. However, if you want to pick your own speaker from the market, you need to know every details of the receiver, that how much power it has for each channel, whether you should go for a tower speaker or bookshelf speaker, etc. Lastly, calibration. There are receivers come with sound calibration microphone to help you to calibrate all the speakers to perform its best. However, at times it still require human intervention to be perfect. For that, one need to invest some time to fiddle with the equalizer to get the best out of it. In case we are not able to solve it on our own and realize it is not sounding the way it is supposed to be, we hire a professional to get this fixed. However, for me, home theater is the best choice to listening to music as well as watching movies. Please note, as I have mentioned earlier, the term sound quality is a subjective matter. It differs from person to person. Whatever is being said in this video, which is my own observation. Hence, please read the specification, listen to the quality first before buying anything. I hope this video is helpful for you. If you like this video, please hit the like button. And please subscribe to grow this family. We are gonna see you soon with a new topic. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.